Hi, I'm Rachel, one of the ICU technicians, and today I'm going to go over feeding through a PEG tube and also the care and maintenance of one. It's a tube that is placed through the skin directly into the stomach with the help of an endoscope. So what we're going to do is first check the tube site to make sure that there's no leakage or any evidence that it has come displaced. And we're going to do that by looking right under here. We have a stockinette covering our kitty's spot here to keep it from getting dirt and from being dragged around or pulled on. So as you can see here, the site looks nice and dry. She is a little sensitive about it. There's no evidence of any leakage, so it looks good on that end. The reason this cat had the tube placed was because she had cervical trauma, so there's a great deal of swelling around her esophagus. She did have a tracheal tear, so she didn't want to eat, and we don't want to do any more trauma to the site that's already there, which is why we did not place an esophagostomy tube. So this tube holds about 5 to 6 milliliters. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and just flush some water in first to clear the tube and make sure that she's okay with the contents hitting her stomach. I want to watch her for signs of gagging, any kind of distress, anything that shows that she's not reacting well to the feedings. She didn't show any sort of reaction for that, so I feel comfortable continuing with a feeding here. The diet I'm going to use for this is Hill's AD. It's a very soft diet. It actually doesn't even need to be further blenderized. I'm able to just scoop it directly out into a syringe, and then it does push very smoothly through these large gauge tubes. So we've been giving her feedings of 12 milliliters of AD every 4 hours. We'll slowly increase the quantities and decrease the amounts as she begins to handle it okay, but this is only her second day and only 12 hours into feeding, so we're still going slow on that. I'm gonna attach the syringe here. You will sometimes get the pressure of the stomach contents will push back a little bit, which is where that fluid just came from. And I have about 5 to 6 milliliters just to fill the tube, so I'm gonna go ahead and push that slowly into the tube, but a little quicker than once I give it the feeding when it's at the stomach. So I'm 6 milliliters in, I have all of it within the tube, so now is when I'm gonna start kind of the slow, steady push of it hitting her stomach. So I'm probably gonna start by just pushing about 1 milliliter into her stomach and see how she responds. During this cat's initial feedings, when they first started, she was having some slight discomfort reactions during the feeding. She was doing exaggerated swallowing and gagging, so they did back off, and that's why I'm going very slow with her and want to watch her very carefully for any reactions. She still seems to be doing okay, so I'll push a little bit more. Okay, so I've just finished the feedings. Half of the feedings is still within the tube as we discussed, the volume is in there. I'm going to now give her medications via her PEG tube. This is really nice for a cat, especially in her condition, that might be hard to give medications to anyway. With all the trauma to her cervical area, it's good to not have to fight with her, scruff her, or do any more trauma to that area by trying to get pills in her if she's unwilling to eat. So this makes it very easy. I'll disconnect my syringe of the food, and I will connect the first medication, the Clavamox. And I still want to push it slowly because I have to remember that I'm still pushing the food through there before the medication gets there. When I disconnect to put the other medication on, I'm going to try to kink the tube a little bit so that medication doesn't come back out. So I've just finished giving the rest of the medication, the Baytril, and now I'm just going to flush the tube clear to make sure all that medication does get into her with another 6 milliliters of water. I go a little bit faster now that all the food is in to make sure the force of the water pushes all the medication in so it doesn't just sit in the tube. So again, I'm gonna kink the tube a little bit so that that doesn't come back. And then cap that off. And depending on what kind of tube and what size it is, there's many different options for keeping the tube from being drug on the ground or getting the patient entangled in it. So we have a pretty long tube. We've just used some vet wrap to encircle it. We have a stocking net cover to keep the site covered and the tube kind of held up under that. And then a little onesie on to secure it a little bit more over that, which has been working, and she seems very comfortable like that. Just the last notes are to always check the site, as PEG tube and sites do often get infected based on their location. So it is important to check that several times a day and to recheck with your regular vet if you notice any signs of infections and to hold on feedings until you do so.